login.
Accepted.
What's up, my YouTube friends? It is me, HackHappy, back with another video. Now, today we're not going to do any hacking, but we are going to do something that I find very cool, and if not cool, certainly convenient. We're going to install Kali Linux into Windows. That's right, I said into Windows. Not in a virtual machine in Windows, but literally install Kali in Windows. Okay, maybe not literally, but you will have all the same tools and you will be able to run them directly from inside Windows. No longer do you have to run a virtual machine in order to have access to a bash prompt or run any sort of Linux-based tools that you may desire. And not only that, you'll also be able to run X-Windows programs. That's right, you'll even be able to use your favorite GUI applications. So, as you may or may not know, I do believe it was September of last year, Microsoft released the update 1607, which includes the Linux subsystem. That's right, Windows has included Linux with Windows. So if you so desire, you can choose to install the Linux subsystem directly from Windows, and that's what we're going to do right now. So let's get into it. First thing first, you need to set the execution policy. This will allow me to run my PowerShell script. All right, so what we have here is a PowerShell script, and I'm gonna walk through this script real quick just so you can see what's going on. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to check to make sure the current version of Windows is greater than the 1607 update. So basically you have to have the 1607 or greater version of Windows 10 in order to have the Linux subsystem available for you to install. Now, once that is done, in order to install the Linux subsystem, you must enable developer mode. Now, like I said earlier, you can do this via the Windows configuration settings through the GUI interface. However, I wanted to show you guys how to do this from a programmatically standpoint. Programmatically standpoint, that does not sound right. But you get what I'm saying. I wanted to show you how to do this with code. So basically what this is doing is just modifying a registry value that will enable developer mode, as you can see here. And then finally, we'll execute this command, which will enable the Linux subsystem. So I'm going to save this file. Do not want to restart right now, in the middle of something. All right, so now I'm going to execute this script. You can see it's running and it's going to start installing, well, not installing the subsystem, but enabling the subsystem so it can be installed. Okay, perfect. Now that is installed. Now before we continue, we're going to need to restart the computer. And we're back. Holy shit, that took forever, but we are updated. We have the Linux subsystem enabled and we can now continue. So I'm gonna fire up a PowerShell. An administrative PowerShell at that. And now, what we're going to do is actually install the Linux subsystem, because basically all we've done up to this point is merely enabled it. So now we actually have to install it. Now, you can literally just type bash at this point. Get into my VM, there we go. And it will begin the installation for the Linux subsystem. And it's going to ask you a bunch of questions, and you're going to answer these questions if you want this Linux subsystem installed. However, if you don't like to be questioned by anybody, I got something just for you. So we're going to go ahead and close out of that. We're going to listen to my phone beeping at me. And I'm going to look for something that I have seemed to lost. Where did it go? There it is. Okay. So if you don't want to go through the process of answering all the questions and doing all that stuff, there is a quick, snazzy, jazzy way to just have it install automatically, accept all the defaults, and just get it installed. And this is what I use whenever I want to reinstall the subsystem in a automatic fashion. So I'm going to paste in the command here. This VM is running so ridiculously slow. Come on. Did I not copy it? I have the hardest time with copying and pasting. Okay, there we go. So the command is /xlrun /install/y. So we're going to hit enter on that, and as you can see now, it is downloading everything it needs to download for the Linux subsystem. And then once that's complete, it's going to extract all those wonderful, beautiful files that is going to make your life so much more easier. Okay, this is actually going to take a while, so I'm just going to go ahead and pause the video. And I will jump back in 2 seconds. Boo. I think that was 2 seconds. I'm not really sure. Anyways, it is almost done. Installation was successful. It's doing some finishing up work, but we basically now have Bash installed, which is Linux in essence. So let's go ahead and run it. I'm gonna wait for my slow computer, and kaboom, there we have it. Bash on Ubuntu on Windows. So let's go ahead and hit enter on that. Ubuntu, by the way. And there you have it. Look at that, guys. That is a Linux prompt, and we are freaking in Windows. That is so awesome, so convenient. It's just cool. Why did it take till 2017 for Windows to freaking get on board? So let's just show you. Where the heck are we? Okay. There's a password file. That's so cool. Yes, awesomeness. Okay, so now we have Linux installed on Windows, but we're not quite finished yet, because basically all we have at this point is the Linux subsystem. So we have the basic Bash system and a lot of the common programs that you would expect to use from a Bash prompt. Now, not everything is there, but you can put it there if you like to. So while Kali doesn't have any sort of installation tool for this Linux subsystem in Windows 10, but what you can do is just manually install all of the Kali tools that come with Kali. And then in essence, you have a Kali enabled Windows 10 system. It's pretty cool. Okay, so I've created a script, and I'll provide links in the description for all of these scripts so you can just download them. If I can actually find what I did with it, I have so much crap. All right. Here, I'm doing some further development, but I'm done. think this is a working script. I forgot. I made some changes to it, and I'm not sure if I've tested it since then. So let's see if this works. This might not work at all. I might need to edit. So I got a Python script that's going to do all the heavy lifting of getting Kali installed. It looks like I'm just incapable of copying and pasting. All right, perfect. So this is a script. This is basically just going to go through, set up your current system so the repos and everything are there, and then it's going to install all the tools for Kali. So I'm going to close this out, and then I'm going to run it. And there we go. It is now downloading all of the Kali tools and installing them. But this is where I'm gonna stop for today. I know, I'm gonna leave you hanging, but don't worry, on the next video we're going to install Xmin, which will then allow us to install, or rather run, all of our favorite X Windows applications directly from inside Windows 10. So if you like this video, please throw me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not subscribed, and I will see you on the other side.
Login acceptance.